Hey Sagittarius, welcome to your week ahead. And this is where we look at some general themes for the week ahead and your channeled message, some events that may be unfolding. And keep in mind that eclipse season is a little hinky, right? Because we have things closing out and I feel like we were all really like Pisces full moons. What is it with them? Like they're so heavy and so even physically heavy. Like oh my gosh. So, but I like what I see that is emerging, and I think it's going to be. I actually think that 2025 is going to be an amazing year. I say that about every year. This year was amazing too. So if you're looking for personals, please check out the link in my description and then we will go through like a general spread. But let's get into it, Sag, because I think that here's the tower again. We're gonna keep seeing the tower. And that's a fact, Jack. 'Cause under the deck is justice, and I feel like this is as we move in to Libra season. I don't know, is like today Libra season? I didn't even look at it. Somebody will let me know, but justice is here, and that really is a sign of like justice can be the truth, it could be you're realizing some truths, definitely some things that you maybe need to move on from, even where to focus your energy, a more effective way of putting work into things and what not to put work in. And I feel like the universe is going to show we're not doing this anymore because it no longer exists. And it's a very interesting energy. And the Chariot's very positive, y'all. I love the Chariot because we're moving, moving, moving. We have figured it out. We're figuring out how to make things work, and I feel like also what doesn't need your attention anymore is just gonna go. Yeah, you're not gonna need to do that, but it may also be, these stress points of it being shown to you, maybe you didn't know. Love it. So, your channeled message, a sculpture of self is like, I really feel like that's who we're becoming. And there is this energy for you of stepping into who you become, who you're becoming, and expressing yourself from that point. But it does feel like there are some people perhaps that are stuck on like who you used to be and not really like in tune with all of the work that you've put into yourself or all of the healing. And I mean, that can be really frustrating, right? It can be because there's something about you here that has definitely changed. Maybe it's the way that you express yourself, and the truth is that this kind of new you is going to create opportunities for you that have been, and we're seeing the Three of Wands reversed again, which is like, it's going to become clear that like your new life was stalled for a reason. It had to do with who you were becoming, and you may really find that part of your healing is definitely moving away from people who don't want to accept that, who almost won't let you move into this new version because they want you to be that old version. And often we find that, and like move away from people in our lives who are a little too stuck on who we used to be. And so you may really be like expressing yourself on that kind of tip, right? But you've been waiting for this and you're going to see things manifesting that maybe you have felt have been really stalled, like the Three of Wands is your new life, your new direction, your new life. And I think that that is because with Temperance being here, it's really talking about it's time because you've figured it out, And sometimes as we are stepping more in order to embrace a new life or step into a new life or a new phase, we have to become that new person. And so maybe, you're realizing this week that that's what it's been about. And the delay could have really been other people who have wanted to hold you back. I do feel like that is going to become very crystal to who those people are. And it's not like, it's kind of like the same mode of reasoning, like why we don't have the same friends we had when we were 5 years old. Because we're just not the same people anymore. And I feel like that may be something that you're figuring out. And it's not bad necessarily. It just doesn't work for what you're trying to step into. And so I think that's super beautiful. And on the bottom is the Knight of Wands and the King of Pentacles and Judgment. So there's definitely you stepping into a new life and the right people being there to help. I love it. Doesn't get any better than that. And, situations unfolding, I kind of feel like you are really, it's kind of the same message where you are realizing, you're maybe you didn't really see the people who have been holding you back very clearly. But it's going to become very clear that maybe even what you thought was like a great relationship just wasn't. Was kind of codependent, right? And that can be hard. I do feel like you're realizing that certain relationships in your life, certain people in your life just hold you back. And there's a need for you to move on. It's very interesting because like the action and the energy says that, at this time the situation is in a state of flux and anything could happen. It being there with the Ace of Cups, all of this is coming from a place of love for yourself. And it's sometimes it's like the more we are on, I don't know if you've ever heard the saying about how the more I heal, the more I don't like people. You know what I mean? Like you just see a whole lot of things. And I do feel like you are open to these situations changing, but it's like you're moving forward because you have been through this healing, through this spiritual journey, but other people aren't. And that's the problem, that like they're prisoners of their conditioning. And I mean, Sagittarius is spiritual, so we always see beyond that. I don't think that we do tend to be prisoners of conditioning because we always want that different life. But what you're seeing is that something about some of these relationships just wasn't healthy for you because they kept you there. Almost like they kept you in convention. And I do feel like you are holding space, like for things to change. But right now, you have to kind of value yourself, you know? And I do also feel like you may be a little confused as to why you feel the way you do. Like, why do I feel so disappointed? Why? It's not per se like they did something specifically wrong. You just know that, like, they keep you in a space that doesn't allow for you to move on to the next thing. And so this is why you're breaking free. I mean, you did give it time to see if it could grow, if it could, you know, if they would grow, but it just doesn't feel that way, Sage. And I know, like, that doesn't mean everyone's going to be breaking up, right? Or this doesn't necessarily have to mean romantic relationships, but you know, we're always changing, and like you've changed so much that you know this happens, and you and there is there was sort of kind of a clinging energy here. Yeah, look at this, the world, the Eight of Swords. Yeah, you're moving, the Six of Swords, definitely moving beyond things that have kept you stuck. And wow. Well, Sag, that is amazing. So those could be the things unfolding this week. Look out for that. Okay, Sag, part two. Like, there is something happening. Now we see loyalty reversed, which I really think is just about you're achieving something, pursuing something that you feel has promise, or this definitely has to do with that. Maybe it's whether you should pursue it. And you're not going to be getting help from others in this. This is something definitely a you thing. I do feel like you're thinking about it. And underneath the deck, I mean, it could be with the devil being here that there are people who aren't for it. But it also speaks to ending a karmic cycle because of the devil and the Ace of Wands. Like, you know, the devil are the things that we're tied to, you know, and that may, in the past, maybe that was you not pursuing things because of other obligations, because of other people. I mean, we also saw that in the other part, you know, but I feel like this is an opportunity coming towards you that, I mean, it's not like happening right in the moment. There is some stuff to do first. So in order for you to take this, you're just kind of finding out about this opportunity. And in order for you to do that, there are some things for you to clean up, specifically in terms of these obligations. You know, some things to take off your plate before you can approach this. But it does feel like you're excited about this. It really does. With the Page of Wands, Temperance and the Chariot. And we saw Temperance and the Chariot in the other part. And so, you know, this definitely seems like whatever this opportunity is, this is the time for it. It really is. So maybe that's like something you're going to want to do to like make sure that you're able in your life to pursue a new opportunity. You know, it's just like I say to other people, it's like sometimes That's just like the details. Like if there's something that you're wanting to do, like move or quit your job or something, you have to kind of make sure a little bit that your ducks are in a row. Like I've moved a lot in my life, like a lot. And one thing I learned about moving is that you have to be prepared. You have to know what you're stepping into, and that may mean, laying groundwork for it first, and that may be something that you're considering, right? Yeah, but what you don't need to focus on is, anyone from the past or anyone that you're close to that wants to drag you back to the past, or kind of slow you down. Because we see the Queen of Wands and the Eight of Wands, and it could be people pulling on your heartstrings to say, oh, this can wait, blah, blah, blah. And it's just calling for you to not give that any mind, because look, the World again. The Queen of Swords. The Star. Oh my goodness. And the Five of Cups. I mean, I feel like, yes, take your time making this decision, get all the information, do what you have to do to be ready for it. But it's also kind of saying that you would be sorry if you skip this opportunity. You would regret it. Okay. Wowza. And the one thing that you can take away from this too is that, like, with it being pages, you're only getting the opening information. So it's not like this offer is made or the opportunity comes up and you have to jump on it that day. No, but you kind of have to decide whether you're pursuing it, because there are things that you have to do. Wowza, okay. So let's take a look at the lesson this week. What's the lesson for Sagittarius? What's the lesson? What's the lesson for Sagittarius? Think first before you judge. Release your guilt, swim away from this situation. Yeah, I do really feel like this may be you in the sense of responsibility that you feel towards others. Very interesting, Sagittarius. So let's see what energy the universe wants you to embrace this week. What energy do you want Sag to embrace this week? Oh, Pisces. Dare to dream, friends. Trust the inner fire, the solar plexus chakra, and harness the energy of self-belief and determination. I mean, trust what your gut is telling you, and what your soul wants. And you can do that. Like, you don't have to be, like, it's asking you to be compassionate to others, right? But it's also, I would say too, any decision you make has to be made on your own, because Pisces does a lot in isolation. It could be that all of this started during the eclipse. It could still be yet to show its face, right? So let's see what the mindful message is for Sagittarius. My voice is so. I would say fall allergies, y'all, but we haven't had fall here yet. It's still 95 degrees. Not a turning leaf to be found. What's the message for Sag? Okay. Recharge. I invite magic into my life always. Every day I grow my connection to the earth. If I'm feeling low, I simply step outside and appreciate the natural miracles in this life. It's asking you to go outside in nature. Talk to the trees. If you're needing answers, Sag, do it. I do it all the time. So that's what I have for you. I hope it really helps. Toodles.